Hello and welcome to another video. I'm going to basically dive right into OpenTTD because I have quite a few things to discuss about why I've not been here and things like that, and I'm sure that you just want to kind of see me play and you don't really care about what I have to say. So I'm going to just load this up. What we did in the last episode is we constructed the rail network in Reddingstone, and in this part what we're going to do is basically expand from that and create an accompanying bus system. So a system of bus lines which basically serve the areas that the metro and the rail does not cover. So we're going to link all these towns and villages up. Now I could plan this out, yes, that, you know, is an option, and what I am going to do is add ferries as well, but for bus routes I'm just going to brute force and add lots of bus lines. Okay, right after I build an extension to this metro station. I'm kind of just going to address a bit of an elephant in the room. Obviously, quite a few of you know I'm from the UK, and there's a certain brand of cereal that's been in all the news recently known as Brexit. And I'm kind of just going to address, because quite a few people have private messaged me asking if I'm okay and stuff, and it's like, yeah, don't worry, it's all fine. I mean, don't get me wrong, I appreciate that you messaged me and stuff, but there's no need to worry. I'm not outsourcing my videos. There's not going to be any duty tax on watching this, so it doesn't matter. But that does explain why I've been away. That's basically, I don't think anyone in this country, or, well, from the looks of things, other countries, actually expect just to go and do it. Our work, I had a few days off after to where I was like, yeah, I'm going to record, sure, I'm going to sit down and do this, and no, not at all. My work were like, nope, you've got to come in, we've got a big meeting to discuss the effects of this, and what, oh no, I just want time to myself, I just want time to record OpenTTD videos, and then they go, record what now? And then I go, YouTube videos, and then, yeah, people start asking, and that's exactly why I don't mention it to work, which is why I'm always like, yeah, okay, I'll work. Well, I can't really say anything otherwise. Right, before I carry on with this, where am I going to start the first route? I'm going to start a bus route which goes from Bromway across to Trentbourne and up here. I'm going to leave the bus routes that we have in place because they seem sufficient. Though, what we could do is, so that's the coastline, where does this go? Right, so we'll add a few more of these buses as well. I'll increase the frequency. But yeah, so I've kind of been catching up with the fallout of that. We're a UK company and, we're in the FTSE 100, so it's not too bad. At least we've got security of work and such. But a bit crazy what's happening. A bit crazy. We'll get through it, though. We always do. I suppose, you know, my plan for this video, I was going to suggest that this peninsula actually forms its own independent body away from the rest of this union, but nope, that's gone up in ashes now. Sorry, Reddingstone, you're sticking to this economy, and oh god, I'm not even going to get into it. It's opened up lots of cans of worms that it did not need to be opened up. Why? What's with the huge queue? Why is there a massive, massive queue? Oh well. So we've added more coastline buses. They'll space themselves out. Then what other buses did we have? We have this one, which... oh, it's literally just a... okay. They can stay as they are. I'm going to make a new bus route. But I will add, when this fucking pile of buses disappears, another bus stop here. Please move quickly. Oh my god, no. I give up. Right. To start making routes. First of all, though, I could do with expanding the bus station because there are already two tracks in and I want a third one. So we're going to do this. Reddingstone. Right. Where is the bus depot? It's there, isn't it? We'll have the Mercedes Bendy bus. And what we want to do first, I think, is let's create a bus route which goes up through Pruddingbury and then across in like an arc around here, like the main cities. So we'll have start and stop, well, here. then so what it can do is start from Reddingstone, go up, yeah, through this route here, basically to Pruddingbury. From Pruddingbury, it can head over to Dradston. And then across, so we've got a road here. See, that's the thing, like, this needs connecting here, which is why I'm examining the routes. That can go through to Marston. So yeah, basically that's the reason I couldn't record. I got called into work. And just as a heads up, right now, it's very unlikely I'll be able to do two OpenTTD videos a week for the next month or so. Now, I really want to, and don't get me wrong, the status quo is going to be that I'm going to aim for that. But the problem that I have is that at my work, 1 second, I was going to think of a name for this. Reddingstone Arc Line. I'm categorizing these, aren't I? Which I've not done with them. Oh, shit. Oh, well, I'm going to start a new habit now. So let's have Reddingstone Bus Network Arc Line. Put that in there. So that's Reddingstone Arc Line. Which bus number is that? It'd be that one there. See how long that carries on. Oh my god, look at the trams wharf. I've put too many on. God damn it. I'm really tempted to redo the trams. Though I would do that off camera. Because it's just not interesting enough for me to film. We'll see how it goes though, it might even out. Okay, so that's one there. We'll start that auto-filling and then we'll come back to do its bidding afterwards. Yeah, so basically, my work of two people, there's a team of five of us, including myself, and two of our staff have basically just got graduate jobs, so there's me and two other people left, and that's it. So I'm working like 6 days a week for the next few weeks. It's like, oh my god. It's kind of good to save up money, I guess, but really, I would rather be at home recording videos than I would be working. It is handy that at least it's around the corner now, and you know, that does help, but still. And even now, like, Ashley's literally just been given, like, a store promotion to, like, a store in Manchester City Centre, which means that even she's not going to be using the train now. So I went from, like, doing these videos, like, oh, yeah, I'm, like, a commuter. Oh, my God, I'm, like, one of you. Oh, I see trains every day to, oh, okay, yeah, I walk under a train bridge to work. Look, how cool am I? Guys, please. Please, guys, be my friend. I like trains, honestly. But, oh, man, it's weird. It's just been such a strange time. I've been kind of stuck in this limbo of, oh, my God, what the hell is happening to this country? Like, I'm more optimistic than I was now. I think we'll do okay, but it's just been a weird set of events. You have, like, Boris Johnson, who's decided with most gusto to step down from the leadership race. It's like, right, okay, that's just... It's really interesting to watch everything unfold, but Jesus, some crazy shit is happening. I'm going to do a line that goes up here. Mate, we're doing lines, yeah? Well, I was going to say it's like school, but, mate, bit of crack cocaine in the school then, yes, bro. Not that I'm advocating the use of that whatsoever. It just fit with what I said, because it sounded like I was implying that I was doing lines. That's too close to this bus stop, so let's extend this one. And have a little kind of junction thing there. Do any buses come down this way? No. So what we'll do is have a bus station there. Love one here as well. And that's Flon Hill, which needs extending a bit. And then it can come up here, I think. So you've got to be careful where this bus is going to go now. Because I don't want to kind of cut off any non-stop routes. Although I guess they are non-stop, aren't they? So it doesn't really matter, but still. No, it could go through to Condingville straight after that. And then from there, I'll have a bus stop there. And then one here. So we can kind of have it go off the beaten track a little bit. Extend that. A bus stop there. And then what we'll do is demolish this little house. Get out! We're building a road through your house. You can fucking live with it. Or you'll die with it. Whoa, that was aggressive. Okay. Yeah, that's it. And then we'll have a bus stop around here somewhere. I like building bus routes in the sense of you get to tidy up the towns and you can keep an eye on the... You'd use that. You can keep an eye on the rail networks. So you can see here, everything seems to be ticking by. I'm suspicious of how quiet this is. Is everything congested somewhere? Does anyone ever get that feeling? Like, hang on. All the trains don't seem to be here. I bet they're all, like, queuing at one little junction, waiting forever. No. That's fine. Just there don't seem to be many trains. Electric corridor. I'm just going to check this. No, I've definitely put all the trains in. I was thinking, hang on, have I set this so... There are a lot in the depot, I'll give them that, though. Why are there so many in the depot? Why is it 18,000 ticks early? Maybe, okay, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt that I've just set those off. And I think I did just set them off and let them work out their own routes. So that's fine. That'll probably populate. It's the words that I'm trying and failing to get out of my mouth. Right, so that will go up to Bhutan. What we'll do is we'll have a bus stop at this end of town. Now, this can be called Bhutan. No, apparently not. It's going to be called Bhutan Docks. And what we are also going to do alongside these bus routes is create. And I'm also going to put a thing here, actually, the side of it. We're going to create a wonderful ferry network. Look how cool that looks. Yeah, that looks the biz. Looks the business. Can't be talking about business now because it's all moving away from the UK. So, you know, hey, hey. Relevant but upsetting jokes. Oh. Also, you know, I am only kind of joking about all this. Don't fear me for my political differences. Like, I'm not bothered. Like, some people argue they're, you know, like, people at work have been properly, like, arguing, like, well, I've been Leave, I've been Remain, this. It's like, well... You know, what's happened. You know, you had a stance and an opinion before, and, you know, now you... What's happened's gone on. Just got to live with the consequences now, haven't we? Nothing we can do now. Well, some people think we can stop this referendum, but, you know. In the sense of there's not really a whole lot you can do. Just get on with it and enjoy your lives. At the end of the day, no matter what anyone says, you're... We're all just organisms floating around on a rock in space, which is just something out of nothing, and it could very easily just not be here, and you'd not even be here pondering as to why you're upset about a decision about the politics of a country. So what we should probably do is carry on with our lives and understand that, you know what, shit just happens, and you should just be grateful for the fact that you're around to see the shit itself happen. I just said shit itself. Oh, what's happening? Oh, no. Why is it doing this? Oh, I trusted you. And you've let me down. Non-stop. I thought we were strangers to love. There we go. Oh, got it. You know the rules, and so do I. Right, sorry. I won't sing that because it's probably going to annoy someone. It's just a case of I don't know how else to tell you how I'm feeling and, you know, how I want to make you understand. And obviously next door decide that now is the perfect time when I'm recording a video for the first time in ever. Trams! It's the perfect time to get their Sky installed. Now, I'll explain, because as I was saying that, I realised that not many people would know what I was, what the hell I was talking about. But over in the Great Britain, United Kingdom, England kind of setup we've got going here, we have a company called Sky who does our, it's basically like our satellite TV. Strange, like in America you have quite a lot of TV providers that kind of go through the same thing, as to the best of my knowledge. And let me just put this Reddingstone Bootown stopper. But over here we have like one company that does satellite TV, and that is Sky. So if you want satellite TV, then it's them or no one. Enjoy. We have one that does cable. Why is that one stopped? Can't remember why that one's there. So we have one cable provider. And then the normal copper kind of ADSL broadband lines has got like tons of different providers. For some reason that's, yeah. They're like, yep, everyone can have, you know, all help yourself to broadband lines because, you know, not like there's congestion or anything. It's not like companies constantly say, oh yes, 17 megabytes broadband, which is actually like 2 megabytes and stuff. But oh no, okay, satellite and cable, the higher capacity means of broadband distribution. Nope, they're one company only. Like, good job. Good job, guys. Oh my god. Though, I guess, you know, if compared to what I've heard it is in America, it's very cheap broadband over here. Broadband is cheap. We do good deal in this country, yes? You want broadband for pornography? Yes, it's no problem. We give you that, but government, our government did say no, you don't watch pornography. Yeah, there are actually kind of like government blocks on certain websites, of which I've kind of only noticed torrents so far, which is amusing. How else will I find my train pornography? Oh my god. Look at this shitstorm. Like, why? I'm sorry I keep coming back to these trams, but I'm really concerned. I'm going to have a look over, but I'm going to give them a bit of time. I'm going to stick with this and... God, my hope is dwindling. Oh, man. Okay. I mean, I just want to click on one, and it's going to say, like... Oh. God, why? Why? No, phone, you can't cheer me up. I'm upset at these trams. 2000. We'll see if that has any impact on this. So we've had a second bus route put in. We actually, do you know what it is? We could probably put one more bus route down there, and I think that's kind of it. It's going to wait. I don't like Facebook, but I'm going to turn off my notifications. Facebook is just, oh man. In fact, yeah, I could rant about Facebook for a while. I've got another, we're looked to be about 18 minutes in. Do you know what? I'm going to rant about Facebook. Right, Facebook pisses me off for the following reasons. One, it has lots of people on it for the public. And I don't have good experiences with people in public because a lot of them are amazing, lovely, nice people, but some of them don't have the best opinions. And having those paraded around on the internet and letting anyone kind of say, here's my sometimes close-minded opinion on why I dislike this person or these things, is not a good idea. Secondly, Facebook is happy to make money off, well, anything. If it's a copyrighted video, if it's someone's hate speech, if it's an attack on another person, it doesn't matter. Facebook does not care less as long as it's making money. It really doesn't. And I know there's going to be people who kind of stick up for Facebook and go, oh, well, you know, it's a free service, what do you expect? And I get that. I really do get that. But I have specifically seen certain circumstances with personal family members where there have been kind of like libelous legal allegations randomly posted on Facebook, and Facebook does not want to know. It wouldn't even remove them. It's like, nope. It's just like, it's bizarre that such a huge website, which, let's be honest, I mean, you can make a website, yeah, but with a website like Facebook, it's huge, you know. So many people use Facebook. You do have some moral responsibility to ensure that you're actually providing a safe environment for people. I mean, it's not just a niche little website anymore. When you have like most of the population on the site and most of the population use it to share information and keep up to date, you have a moral obligation to ensure that you're providing a service which meets the demands of your people. And the demands of the people are that it's you know, it's the same as life, really. Safety, and it's always online, which it just tend to be. To be fair, it is a robust system. I will give it that. But yeah, I do not trust it. It's so corporate and it's such a sellout. Twitter is much better, which is why Yeah, here's my shameless promotion, guys. You can follow me on Twitter. No, you don't. If you don't want to, if you hadn't thought about following me on Twitter before now, then you don't want to follow me on Twitter. So do not do that, because it's just pointless. Don't follow me for the sake of it. Follow me if you want updates on videos. I typed video as a Freudian slip there. What can we call this? The Slanly Slow and Easy Special. Oh no, I can't put a number on the end. Okay. Slanly Slow Rider. The Granny Express. The Bingo Shuttle Bus. Where I used to live actually had a bingo shuttle bus. I will just point that out right now. There was a bus route which was specifically designed. Why did it... What is it doing? What happened there? Is it just me or did it do like a full 360? I'm going to demolish that and put that through there. Okay then. So that's the three bus routes made. Sorry for the yawning, I have actually been working today. I'm that committed to providing content for you, even though it is late, that I don't even have a day off for like another week. And I'm like, no, I've managed to sneak out of work early. Look, you can even see down here, it's 16:04 on the 1st of July. I have snuck out of work damn early, and I'm like, I'm going to make the most out of this. I'm literally just going to record until the end of the day. Right, okay. So those bus routes are up. While those are auto-filling, I am going to add some ferries. We're going to make this a nice ferry affair. I'm going to put lots of ships down here. I've got that uncomfortable feeling. Oh yeah, I was talking about Sky, wasn't I? Yeah, so next door neighbours are having Sky put up, which basically means that someone's installing a satellite dish on the side of their house, and we live in a terraced house, so that doesn't go well, because it means that there's a guy who can basically see into what I'm doing. And he can't, you know, there's lots of secrets here that I don't want even want you guys knowing. I mean, come on. Who records videos with pants on? I mean, this is like 2016. So, you know, I don't want him seeing my tram system, how it is. I want to be proud of my tram system, damn it. And here this guy is, thinking he's the business, thinking he's the fucking bee's knees, because he gets up in the morning and decides that he's going to make a living fitting satellite dishes. No. Let's stop this fast right here. I need to pull you back and make you realize you're not the boss of me. I'm gonna make videos, damn it, and there's nothing you can do to stop me or impede my progress. Can you tell that I'm bored? Can you tell I have run out of things to talk about? Where can we put the docks in Rinwood? In fact, it's probably a bit too small to have docks. Let's have them as nice and big. And yes, that if you can hear any background noise, that is the drilling of the wall. It is not a flatulent sound effect put on for humorous comedic value. Well, I suppose if fart sound effects had comedic value, the value would be that of the pound sterling. Burn on me. Let's have a look. Oh no, I've got no GRS for ships. I've got a hovercraft and a ferry. And I'm... No, I'll do the hovercraft. More the ships, yes? If I do that, is it gonna actually find a way there? Or is it gonna shit itself and try and go through the land? No, it looks to be okay. We'll have some docks in Fonninghall. See, I'm just going to connect all these up and then it'll just create a bustling kind of a system. Yeah, I need to attach that onto the bus station, don't I? Okay, and then we'll have one in Slanley. You have done well, Slanley. I shall reward you with your dock. Let's create that there. So, Trent Bomb. And then we've got quite a lot of these here. So what I'll do is... don't know if this will go around. We'll have Bromway to Fonninghall as one ship, you see. Fonninghall to Reddingstone, even though it's kind of a short trip. Then Reading Stone to Bronway. And then can I do Bronway to Flonhill? Yes. Oh no! A swarm of bees outside is what it sounds like. And then we'll have Hadding Head Cross to Flooding Hall. And then Bronway to Hadding Head Cross. See, look, I mean, this station's doing pretty well. We could do with expanding this a little bit. This town's doing well. It's serving as like a hub to this kind of section of the map. We have a pretty, you know, it's... I feel like I've made a mistake with the generation of this level, and in the next series, I'll rectify this. Let me show you, actually, while I'm waiting for these to auto-fill. Let me show you. Can I open up another instance of OpenTTD? Yes, I can. I'm going to show you what I've been experimenting with, the type of map I'm going to create in the next video. And quite a lot of times, when obviously, because I don't want to work on the Let's Play map when I'm not recording, I have my own map which I go through, which is this one. So I'm going to show you, because this is the kind of... the kind of map I'm wanting to make in the next video. A lot of you have A lot of you have said that you want Steam, and look, this is a huge Steam network. I've tried new generation settings. I've toned down massively the town generation, and oh my god, I've been working on this for about a month, and already it's huge. This is the perfect. Like, I wish I'd recorded this from the start. Like, this network's amazing, there's fucking really long routes, and I've got expresses and branch lines, and there's, like, tram networks everywhere, and it's all oldie time, and oh my god, it's so cool, I love this map so much. Like literally, I have, like, an entire South Coast mainline that literally just goes on and 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 gets congested and breaks down and goes on, and yeah, it's amazing. I'm so happy. This is exactly what I want to try and get out of the next series. So just so you know, yeah, you know, this is the kind of thing I want to try and start making in the next series. I'll be taking all the feedback, basically, from what I've done wrong. Oops, just hit the microphone there. Taking all the things I've done wrong from this kind of series, all the things I should be doing better, and I'm going to feed that back into what I do next, because, you know, it's going to make things more fun, isn't it? So yeah, I just kind of wanted to show you that quickly. Back to this tiny little map, which, I mean, look, Jesus, how many? Like, look, we've filled out this map, and it's already just like a conglomerate mass of just towns. Even Planville, like, Jesus. But, yeah, I mean, quite a lot of that's down to the GRFs and things, and the towns don't quite grow as much in the with the newer sets. And what I might do is, because I've kind of made everything that I need to make, all the furries are kind of doing their own thing. In fact, no, they're not. Let me just add a few more quickly. So I need Flonning Head, or whatever it's called, there. And we'll just do them to Prodingpool Falls as well. They'll at least make the maritime network just seem a bit more busy. I mean, look, it just looks like there's things going on now. It looks like a coastal city. Right, so with that done, what I'm going to do is I'm going to autofill these buses off air, because it's kind of boring, really, isn't it? And listening to me talk is boring enough for you guys. So, yeah, thanks a lot for watching. I appreciate you sticking with me and listening to me and... not muting me. If so, you have muted me. I'm talking to myself. Take care, and I'll see you again in the next video.